If we would all stand while the seniors march in. Audience, you may be seated. I'd like to thank everyone for coming out this evening to help us celebrate our seniors and all of their accomplishments. This senior class is special in a couple different ways. Number one, they obviously will be known as or remembered for being the Corona class. And this group of seniors has went through something that no other class has ever went through before. And through it all, they kept a positive attitude and they were resilient all the way through it. And I'm very proud of them for that. Second, a lot of you guys don't know this about them probably, that this is Holcomb's 100th graduating class. So that's pretty cool. So before we get going, I just want to say how proud of you guys I am. You guys have done an awesome job. Appreciate y'all. And seniors, you may be seated. I will now introduce this year's valedictorian, Eli Morgan. He is the son of Scotty and Sarah Jo Morgan. His organizational involvement includes Beta Club Vice President, SGA President, FFA Chapter President, and Area 16 Sentinel. He was also a member of the FBLA, Drama Club, and Art Club for 1 year. He was also involved in the FCA. Eli had a 4.057 GPA. He also participated in baseball and basketball. Eli's plans are to attend Mississippi State University in the fall and major in agricultural engineering technology and business. Ladies and gentlemen, your valedictorian, Eli Morgan.
On behalf of the 100th graduating class of Holcomb High School, I would like to welcome all. First off, I would like to thank everyone for being here tonight. I would thank all administration staff that contributed to organizing tonight's event. I would like to give a big thank you to all the teachers and staff that have been a part of my journey as well. Most of all, I would like to thank my mom and dad, along with the rest of my family, for always supporting me. As we go through life, we often take the little things for granted. We do not always appreciate things as much as we should. Once we have realized that something special is gone, we then understand how much we should have appreciated it. As we start school and preschool, we really have no clue as to what's going on. All we know is that we're here with our friends and we're just gonna play all day. Grade school is when you actually play less and realize that you're at school to learn. By the time you are a senior, you are ready to get out, I promise. I'm sure that if you would have asked any senior of the class of 2020 what they thought about graduation, they would have most definitely agreed with me. I'm sure that many of you all were just like me at the beginning of this year, but as time got closer and you began to think about leaving, you thought about all the little things that you would miss, while also thinking about all the big events you've been looking forward to. Just as we were wrapping up our year, we were plagued by very unfortunate circumstances. If you were to ask an underclassman what they thought about school cancellation, they would probably have said that they were excited for the break. Contrary to what any underclassman would have said, I can almost guarantee that the senior class was thinking about much more than a break. The seniors were thinking about all the events they had waited years for: senior prom, senior trip, a final walk through the halls, and graduation. Most, if not all of us, were devastated. Once school was forced to close, this gave us a lot of free time to think. I am sure that everyone, including all students, sat at home and thought about all sorts of things. One of the things that came to my mind as to how much I miss being at school. I never thought I would miss seeing a teacher's smiling face or laughing through the halls and at lunch with my friends. All the little things that I never really thought mattered was what I missed the most. Looking back, I took way too many things and moments for granted throughout school. A singer-songwriter by the name of Luke Combs wrote a song about taking things for granted. In Luke Combs' song titled, "Be Careful What You Wish For," he tells about a lack of appreciation for the little things. The opening line of the song, "Couldn't wait to ride out of that one-horse town, didn't see no use in sticking around. I was grinning, busting at the seams," can be compared to the seniors' attitudes at the beginning of this year. While a line from the song's chorus, "Don't know what you got till it's gone, and you're out on your own. All you want is what you can't get back," most definitely describes our attitudes now. Although the current pandemic is troubling, I think that there are many lessons to be learned from it. The number one lesson that I can take away from this is to never take anything for granted and to be appreciative of the smallest of things. Honestly, think about the last time you were actually appreciative of something. This pandemic has allowed me to realize just how fortunate I am. We assume things will stay the same the way they are, which is a part of why we take so many things for granted. If the senior class of 2020 had known that March 17th was going to be their last day, they'd have made the most of it, I can promise you. We would have hugged all of our teachers, laughed with as many friends as possible, and told them all how much we appreciate them and how much they mean to us. Since there is no guarantee with anything in life, class of 2020, I encourage you to seize every opportunity that presents itself. Challenge yourself and overcome all your fears. Be bold, be courageous, grow, follow your dreams, and most definitely learn from your mistakes. We are overcomers, and we will prevail, and we can prevail with a thankful heart and a smile on our face. Thank you, class of 2020, and congratulations on your outstanding achievement. Good luck to all my fellow students in the future.
At this time, I'd like to bring up our salutatorian. Our salutatorian is Addie McClendon. She's the daughter of Mark and Amy McClendon. She was Beta Club president, senior class president, art club vice president, and was a member of FFA, FCA, SGA, academic team, and drama club. Addie had a 4.048 GPA. She also participated in volleyball, basketball, and softball. Addie plans to attend Harding University and major in forensic science. Your salutatorian, Addie McClendon.
I would like to begin by thanking God for getting me to this point in my life. I would like to thank my family for putting up with me, especially when I was younger. For those of you who don't know, I was a brat when I was younger. I would like to thank my mom for always being there for me and pushing me to be my best. I would like to thank my dad for spoiling me and always having my back. Pearson, thank you for being an awesome brother. Although we fought a lot when we were younger, I'm glad we are close now. I really look up to you. Hannah, I'm thankful you are part of my family and that you are always there for me. Holcomb has the best staff members one could ever hope for. If I were to talk about each staff member who has impacted my life, we would be here all night. From the administration and teachers to the office staff and lunch ladies and Daryl, we could not have asked for a more loving and caring staff. Love you all. To the class of 2020. So I thought instead of doing a traditional inspirational speech, I would talk about what I'm going to miss or remember about each one of you. I'm definitely going to miss our class and the fun we've had, even though we procrastinated about everything, especially our homecoming skits. Speaking of homecoming skits, I will always remember Riley Jean's break dancing moves. I think we can all agree they're the best. I will also remember Christina stepping up and helping in our skit this year. We won first place, by the way. Belle, I'm going to miss our talks with Miss Floyd during seventh hour. Hayden, I'm going to miss seeing your smiling face and hearing how you can't wait to leave this place. Taylor, I will always remember Yaki walking down the hall asking, "Are you Taylor Carr?" to everyone until she found you. I will also remember the awesome book table you made. Jose, also known as Josie, I was going to say I remember how nice you are to everyone, but today, some of us went and had lunch after graduation practice, and during the ride home, Eli, Kinsey, and I were talking about the school Washington, D.C. trip. So Josie asked if we saw the Statue of Liberty. Needless to say, this is now my favorite memory of Jose. Hunter, I'm going to miss listening to you and Bailey in second hour. You always make me laugh. Cassandra, I remember the good times we had at Beta Convention this year with the senior squad. Kaylee, I'll never forget you zooming in your car and parking beside me every day. Chloe, I'll always remember our discussion of geography during Beta Convention. Don't forget, Texas is not a part of Mexico. Love you. Haley, I will always remember when we were in elementary school and I told you to watch the fan when you climbed on my bunk bed, but you just wouldn't listen. Cortland, I'll never forget your tab with Mr. Howell. Do you think you'll have it paid off by our 10-year class reunion? Dalton, I will always remember you being tardy and saying, "It's custom with the K." Elijah, when I think of you, I will always think of the roll your shorts movement. Rylan, I'm going to miss your stories about being pulled over and me trying to guess which trooper it was. I'm going to miss fourth hour with Alexis, who was definitely winning Nelson's game of life with her many acres she had to sell. Silver, I will really miss your cute hairstyles. Speaking of hair, Brandon, I'll never forget your big hair and you flirting with all the ladies. Mackenzie Shear, you just came this year, but I will miss seeing your face every day. Sierra, I remember when Miss Bullock had to carry you to the nurse's office because you jumped out of a swing and broke your toe. Jacob, I will always remember your hilarious memes. Dusty, I will miss your sense of humor and your pimp outfit. It's the best. I will always remember Jessica and Brittany fighting over the car keys. And Brittany, sorry I accidentally punched you in basketball practice. No hard feelings, right? Sarah, we have been through a lot together. I'm going to miss seeing and talking to you every day. Will, also known as Wilbur, there is so much I could say. But I have to wonder why your picture is in the student section of our yearbook and not with the office staff. Love you, Will. Eli Ray. What can I say? I'm going to remember you always coming in clutch for skits, especially your most famous role as fairy godmother. I will always remember you having my back no matter what. You're like a brother to me, and I'm going to miss you so much. And last but not least, Kinsey. You have always been my partner in crime since we were in diapers at Miss Winnie's. You have always been there for me. You're like the sister I never had. I'm going to miss you bunches. The class of 2020 will be remembered. No other class's year ended on March 17th because of a pandemic. We had a lot taken from us, such as our senior trip and prom. Through it all, we remained strong. I believe that each and every person in this class will be successful no matter where the future may lead. I wish you the best of luck in your future endeavors. Stay true to yourself and do not forget where you came from. I'm going to leave you with this quote from Winnie the Pooh. You are braver than you believe, stronger than you seem, smarter than you think, and loved more than you'll ever know. I love you, class of 2020. Thank you.
We will now have the address by Mr. Jake Nelson. We'll go ahead and do the video presentation now, and Mr. Nelson will speak as soon as that's over.
It's 2020.
And that video was created by Will Brewer. Great job, Will. We will now let Mr. Nelson speak.
Good evening, and I would first like to start by saying congratulations to the class of 2020 on behalf of all the faculty and staff. And secondly, by thanking you for this humbling experience to be able to talk to you on this special evening. I have always shared a special bond with this class because for some reason, you guys were always eager to listen to my terrible dad jokes or the life lessons that I may share. In doing my research, I find maybe this bond is because Generation Z is the generation of authenticity. With things like DirecTV, Netflix, and Hulu, you can literally watch any show or movie that you could possibly ever want to watch with just the push of a button. Yet you choose to watch ordinary people on YouTube doing ordinary things and simply living life. So instead of giving a vague speech full of cliches, I thought I would convey a message as authentic as a YouTube video from my real life perspective. And remember, if you like this speech, be sure to give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I wanted to speak to you today about success. We hear this word success so often, but what does it really mean? According to the Merriam-Webster Dictionary, success means the fact of getting wealth, respect, or fame. Unfortunately, these terms of wealth, respect, or fame mean something different to all of you. To some of you, it may mean graduating college, getting that dream career, and making a difference in the entire world. To others, it may be landing your first job and making real money to support yourself and starting a family. And to some of you, simply making it to graduation day has already changed your entire world. For these first 17 or 18 years of your life, you have had your goals set for you by our school district, the Department of Education, standardized testing, your parents, and of course, society. Your whole life, you have only known success by what you were told that you needed to accomplish to be successful, engaged against each other to show how successful you really were. But today is different. Today, when you are handed these diplomas, you're also being handed the keys to your new life. Everything that has defined you as a person up to this point doesn't really matter anymore. For the first time, despite any challenges you may have faced, the only person that can stand in the way of your success is you. Though it will take a lot of hard work and maybe more for some than others, and each of you will have very different obstacles to overcome, you have the opportunity to build the life that you want. It's a bit scary, isn't it? Especially in today's world. We as humans are wired to worry about everything we are unsure about. And uncertainty has become the reality of the past 3 months. We hear in the news that we are in unprecedented times and to expect a new normal. As we sit here tonight, I can promise you that the next years of your lives will be filled with many things that you have never experienced, and you'll find new normals will replace the life that you have known as you move away from home, meet new people, and take on tasks like paying bills and making doctor's appointments in the transition of becoming an adult. Do not be afraid of this change. Embrace it and learn to thrive in this new life. Do not let the fear of failure lead to the regret of never trying. In a quote from John Shedd, "A ship in the harbor is safe, but that's not what ships are made for." Don't be afraid to ask for advice or ask for help when you fall on uncertain or troublesome times. You will begin to find out that after all these years, mom and dad kind of know what they're talking about after all. Use every asset at your disposal to help you make good decisions. And as you make these good decisions, you will find yourself surrounded by other people from all walks of life pursuing the same success that you seek. For those of you going to college or tech school, work harder than you ever have before. show up to class every day, and do not procrastinate. Save yourself the stress and ensure your transcript at Christmas doesn't look like a Laura Wibbenmeyer 7-day forecast for the end of April, with highs in the lower 70s and lows in the mid 50s. For those of you transitioning into the workforce, show up on time and take tremendous pride in everything you do, and stay late if you need to. To those of you going into the armed services, thank you for answering the call to protect this great nation, and I hope you proudly represent the hardworking men and women of this community. For whatever path you choose to take, the road won't always be smooth. Life is a bully and will knock you on your butt again and again. Get back up, dust yourself off, and try again. You will soon find it's not about the pursuit of success at all, but simply the pursuit of happiness. Allow yourself to build a life not only bringing yourself happiness, but also bringing happiness to the lives of others. Each and every one of you have very specific and very unique traits and abilities that only you possess and only you can give to the world to bring it happiness. Find out what that is and give it to the world. Lastly, I would like to say in closing, though this year has taken a lot for you, be very grateful for what you do have. As you leave here tonight and every chance you get after that, be sure to give the people that raised you a big hug. They have sacrificed greatly and lost a lot of sleep in doing the best they could to give you a better life. Be thankful for the gifts that God has given you and the time that He has given you with your family and friends. Be thankful for the opportunity to finally come together tonight to celebrate and the memories that you have from your time at Holcomb High School. As we all go our separate ways, I wish each of you in the class of 2020 great success, and above all, I wish you happiness. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Nelson. I will be presenting the alumni scholarships. The first one is for Dusty Willett, valued at $1,000. The next scholarship is for Eli Morgan, valued at $1,000. The next one is for Haley Gage, valued at $1,000. This one goes to Kaylee Furlow, valued at $1,000. The next one is for Chloe Gage, valued at $1,000. The next Holcomb Alumni Scholarship goes to Silver Randall, valued at $500. The next scholarship goes to Addie McClendon, $500. The next scholarship goes to Sarah Williams, valued at $500. The next scholarship goes to Jacob West, valued at $500. The next scholarship goes to Mackenzie Copeland, valued at $500. This next one, a second alternate. The certificate is awarded to Will Brewer, valued at $500. The next one's for the third alternate, and that goes to Cassandra Flores. The last one is for fourth alternate, that goes to Taylor Carr. I will now bring up Ms. Beth True Golden to give the True Way Investing in the Future Scholarship.
Congratulations, class. 100 years that we've been graduating people from Holcomb. That's pretty cool. That you guys got to be the 100th class. Maureen, you've had a lot of stuff to endure these last few months. So just remember one thing. It's got me through these months. Fear is a liar. Fear is a liar and a thief, and it will rob you of your joy and your peace. Remember to put God first, because fear is a liar. And from what I've heard, I don't think you guys have any problem with that, because y'all seem to be fairly fearless. So I think that's a good thing for you guys. I wanted to do something a little different this year. We try to expand this as much as we can each year. And so we've changed some things up, and we're going to announce that these first four people are going to be getting a scholarship for $250 upon proof of a fall enrollment in either a trade school or a two-year college or something that you're enrolled in. So long as you can provide that to Pat Moore, then she will make sure that you get your scholarship. The first one is for Cassandra Flores. The next $250 goes to Mackenzie Copeland. The next $250 goes to Dusty Willett. And the last of the 250 goes to Will Brewer. The next set of scholarships will have alternates. And I always want to take this time to thank someone. This person has to remain nameless. It was part of the agreement. But they have been very, very faithful in their friendship to Kevin by always offering a scholarship in his name after he passed away. So this year we're going to have two alternates, and then we're going to have two $1,000 winners. And just because you're an alternate doesn't mean you're not going to get anything. Just if something happens to one of the winners and they don't fulfill the scholarship, you guys can step in. I think we had some of that happen this past year. So just always remember to stay in touch with Pat. This first one is the second alternate for the $1,000 scholarship. That would be $500 upon enrollment, and then $500 for the following semester. And you do need to maintain a 2.5 grade point average. And that second alternate is Sarah Williams. And that first alternate is Silver Randall. And we add, like I said, we have this person who is a very dear friend of Kevin's. And so we added to that, and so we're giving away the two $1,000 scholarships, as I mentioned. And I could not split a twit. So we're giving $1,000 to Haley Gage and $1,000 to Chloe Gage. And this last one, like I said, we did some different things this year. Instead of giving just a one 4-year scholarship of $1,000, I split it up, and we're gonna give two $2,000 scholarships. And they must maintain a grade point average of 3.0, and they'll get $500 for each semester. And that second alternate is Addie McClendon. And the first alternate, unfortunately, I understand she is not here tonight, and that is Alexis Moore Garcia. And the winners of the two $2,000 scholarships, the first one is Eli Morgan. And the last one is Taylor Carr. Thank you, and once again, congratulations.
Thank you, Ms. Golan. I will now be presenting the Cena State Bank Scholarship. The Cena State Bank Scholarship goes to Sarah Williams, and it's valued at $1,000. Reverend Tom Zisch will now give away the Holcomb United Methodist Church Scholarship.
First of all, we want to pray God's blessing on each of the graduates. We pray that your years ahead will be healthy, wealthy, and wise. And stay in Jesus Christ, and your days will be great. We have three scholarships to present. They are $1,000 each. The first one goes to William Brewer. Our next goes to Taylor Carr. And the third to Cassandra Flores.
I'll now bring up Ms. Skelton to present the Barbara Lemons Williams Memorial Scholarship.
You guys are amazing. You know I love each of you. Next year is not going to be the same without you guys here. Students like you are the reason why that my mom loved Holcomb School so much. You guys are the epitome of that. That's why it's so near and dear to my mother. My mother breathed and bled purple. She was a huge supporter of anything that happened here at HHS. So the fact that we get to continue to allow her to help out Holcomb School, my dad and I, and you know, my dad, Carl Williams, this is our second year to give this scholarship. When I got the list, I didn't know what to do. My dad didn't know what to do. Everyone was deserving. I wanted all of you to have it. I was reminded that the reason my mom wanted this was an alumni scholarship. So, with that being said, I'm extremely pleased to give the Barbara Lemons Williams Alumni Scholarship to Haley and Chloe Gage. I didn't forget. And I did it in the wrong order, so sorry. The alternate, Addie McClendon.
I will now have the students stand one at a time and read off their certificates, awards, or scholarships that they've also received. Eli Morgan, A Honor Roll, Computer Applications Class Award, American History Class Award, Ag Business Leadership Class Award, Physical Education Class Award, Mississippi State Colvard Future Leader Scholarship, Freshman Academic Excellence Scholarship, Non-Resident Tuition Scholarship, Student Body President Scholarship, Valedictorian Scholarship, Murray State Carr Academic Scholarship, Missouri Beta Council Scholarship Finalist, Holcomb Beta Club Vice President Scholarship, FFA Progressive Farmer Scholarship, The True Way Investing in the Future Scholarship, Holcomb Booster Club Scholarship, Kennett Trust Bank Scholarship, and the John C. Casper Memorial Scholarship First Alternate. Addie McClendon, A Honor Roll, SGA for 4 years, Personal Finance Class Award, Daughters of the American Revolution, DAR Good Citizen Award, A-plus Scholarship, Holcomb High School Beta Club President Scholarship, Harding University Scholarship, Holcomb Booster Club Scholarship, Holcomb CTA Scholarship, Holcomb Art Club Scholarship, Holcomb FFA Club Scholarship, First State Community Bank Scholarship, Holcomb Alumni Association, Missouri State Trooper Association, the True Way Investing in the Future Scholarship, Second Alternate, Barbara Lemons Williams Memorial Scholarship, First Alternate. Will Brewer, A Honor Roll, 4-year SGA member, Health Occupation Certificate from Kennett Career and Technology Center, A-plus Scholarship, Missouri Western State Griffin Scholarship, Southeast Missouri State University Copper Dome Scholarship, Missouri State University Promise Scholarship, Three Rivers Achievement Scholarship, MAHEO Scholarship, Holcomb Beta Club Historian Reporter Scholarship, the True Way Investing in the Future Scholarship, 250, Holcomb Alumni Scholarship, second offer. Sarah Williams, A Honor Roll, Health Class Award, A-plus Scholarship, Holcomb Beta Club Scholarship, Cena St. Bake Scholarship, Holcomb Alumni Association Scholarship, the True Way Investing in the Future Scholarship, second offer. Mackenzie Copeland, A Honor Roll, Ag 2 Class Award, A-plus Scholarship, Holcomb Beta Club Scholarship, the True Way Investing in the Future Scholarship, and Holcomb Alumni Scholarship, first alternate. Elijah Hobbs, B Honor Roll. Taylor Carr, B Honor Roll, Zoology Class Award, A-plus Scholarship, Southeast Missouri State University Copper Dome Scholarship, SEMO Residence Life Scholarship, the True Way Investing in the Future Scholarship, Holcomb Beta Club Scholarship, and the Holcomb Alumni Scholarship, fourth alternate. Brandon Santos, B Honor Roll, A-plus Scholarship. Hayden Bridges, Electronics Certificate from Kennett Career and Technology Center. Cassandra Flores, A Honor Roll, 4-year SGA member, A-plus Scholarship, Southeast Missouri State University Copper Dome Scholarship, Southeast Missouri State University Residence Life Scholarship, Holcomb High School Beta Club Secretary Scholarship, the True Way Investing in the Future Scholarship, Holcomb High School FCCLA Scholarship, Holcomb High School Art Club Scholarship, Holcomb Alumni Association Scholarship, third alternate. Dalton Harrelson, Auto Technology Certificate from Kennett Career and Technology Center. Brittany Burris, A Honor Roll, Health Occupation Certificate from Kennett Career and Technology Center, and the A-plus Scholarship. Jessica Burris, A Honor Roll, Health Occupation Certificate from Kennett Career and Technology Center, and A-plus Scholarship. Kaylee Furlow, B Honor Roll, Graphic Arts Certificate from Kennett Career and Technology Center, Arkansas Academy of Hair Design Scholarship, and Holcomb Alumni Association Scholarship. Riley Nunnery, Law Enforcement Certificate from Kennett Career and Technology Center, and the A-plus Scholarship. Hunter Duncan, Marketing Certificate from Kennett Career and Technology Center. Chloe Gage, A Honor Roll, A-plus Scholarship, Holcomb High School Beta Club, True Way Investing in the Future Scholarship, Holcomb FCCLA Club, Holcomb CTA Scholarship, LaFemme Scholarship, Barbara Lemons Williams Memorial Scholarship, Holcomb Alumni Association Scholarship First Alternate, College of the Ozarks Scholarship. Haley Gage, A Honor Roll, Academic Team Award, Photography Class Award, A Plus Scholarship, Holcomb Beta Club SGA Representative Scholarship, True Way Investing in the Future Scholarship, Holcomb FCCLA Club, Holcomb CTA Scholarship, La Femme Club Scholarship, Holcomb Art Club Scholarship, Barbara Lemons Williams Memorial Scholarship, College of the Ozarks Scholarship. Rylan McCormick, B Honor Roll. Jacob West, Electronics Certificate from Kennett Career and Technology Center and the A-plus Scholarship. Belle Boyd, B Honor Roll and the A-plus Scholarship. Corlin Graham, Health Occupation Certificate from Kennett Career and Technology Center and the FCCLA Scholarship. Silver Randall, A-plus Scholarship, Holcomb Alumni Association, and First Alternate for True Way Investing in the Future Scholarship. Dusty Willett, A Honor Roll, English 4 Class Award, Electronics Certificate from Kennett Career and Technology Center, A-plus Scholarship, the True Way Investing in the Future Scholarship, and the John C. Casper Memorial Scholarship. The total value of scholarships for the graduating class of 2020 is $625,926. Good job. And I will now bring up Mr. Ferguson for the presentation of the class.
First, I think it's something to mention. It's wonderful to see a crowd of people here to celebrate the accomplishments of the class of 2020, the historical class of 2020. I've heard many people say tonight that the class of 2020 is special, but I didn't realize that they were special enough that the governor would cancel all restrictions so they could have their graduation during a world pandemic. It's quite amazing. But in all seriousness, I hope that the class of 2020 has listened and learned over the last couple of months, because guys, often life is the best teacher of all. I hope that you've learned that today and tomorrow may never be like yesterday or the day before. So I hope that you learn to embrace the moment. I hope that you learn that this world desperately needs new vision and new leaders. I hope that you have a voice and go out and change the world. And I also hope that you've learned in the last 30 minutes that you have to be flexible and adaptable, because you never know when the lights are going to go out. All right? And then I hope, lastly, that you've learned over the last couple months how important it is to be resilient, because in life you're going to get knocked down and you have to keep moving toward your dreams. So at this time, I told you I wouldn't waste a lot of your time. I want to introduce Mr. Mark McClendon to present the diplomas to the class of 2020. Row one, please stand. Elijah William Hobbs. Mackenzie Michelle Copeland. Sarah Elizabeth Williams. William Jared Brewer. Adriana Carrie McClendon. Eli Ray Morgan. Row one, you may be seated. Row two, please stand. Cassandra Michelle Flores. Hayden Andrew Bridges. Brandon Giovanni Santos. Jose Abraham Cruz. Taylor Grace Page Carr. Row two, you may be seated. Row three, please stand. Riley Jean Nunnery. Kaylee Jill Furlow. Jessica Ann Burris. Brittany Nicole Burris. Christina Marie Jo Taylor. Dalton Connor Harrelson. Row three, you may be seated. Row four, please stand. Rylan Wade McCormick. Mackenzie Leanne Shear. Haley Denise Gage. Chloe Elizabeth Gage. Hunter Lane Duncan. Row 4, please be seated. Row 5, please stand. Dusty McGavin Willett. Silver Faith Randall. Sierra Elizabeth Talley. Cortland Renee Graham. Nancy Geneva Bell Boyd. Jacob Kyle West. Rows 1 through 4, please stand. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the Holcomb High School graduating class of 2020. Thank you. time, the graduates will be located right outside. If you'd like to go out and get pictures and give hugs, they'll be right out front here.